Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to make this dramatically lit theatrical interior wall with text from scratch. Create a new document by going to File and New. Make the size 1550 by 870 pixels with a resolution of 150 pixels per inch. Then, click OK or press Enter or Return. Double-click on the thumbnail of the background, and let's name it Wall Base. Double-click on the thumbnail again to open its Layer Style window. Click Pattern Overlay, and click the tiny arrow next to the pattern. Click the gear icon to open your list of pattern presets, and choose Artist Surfaces. Click OK to replace the current patterns with the patterns from Artist Surfaces. Click the gear icon again and click Small List. Scroll to the bottom and click Brush Pen on Canvas. Click Color Overlay and the Color Box. Type in 332103, then click OK. Change its blend mode to Vivid Light. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. This allows us to modify or adjust the background non-destructively. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and choose Levels. Type in 169 for the white input level. Click the thumbnail of the wall base to make it active, and go to Filter, Render, and Lighting Effects. If you can't access lighting effects, it may be due to one or more of the reasons I listed in the video description. Once the lighting effects window opens, choose Spot and start with these settings. Make the intensity 90, the hot spot 44, the exposure 0, gloss minus 100, metallic 100, and the ambiance 75. Move the spotlight to the center of your document. Go to the top point on the outer circle, and when you see scale width, drag it up to the top or a bit past the top of your document. Go to the side of the outer circle, and when you see scale length, drag it out approximately this much. The inner circle is called hotspot. To adjust its size, you could either drag the bottom point up or down, or type in an amount. Let's type in 28. Then, click OK or press Enter or Return. Go back to Filter, Render, and Lighting Effects, and when the next spotlight appears, drag it straight across approximately this much and press Enter or Return. Repeat this one more time and drag it to the opposite side. We're ready to set our text. Make the top layer active. Photoshop always places the text above the active layer. Open your horizontal type tool and choose a font. I'm using R. Bonnie Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link in the video description or project files. For this font, I'll make its size 123 points. Make it smooth, center alignment, and black for its color. If the color isn't black, just click on it, and when the color picker opens, pick black. Click on your document and type out your text. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. Lower the fill to 55%. Lowering the fill will reduce the text's opacity, but it won't lower the opacity of the effects that we'll be adding to the text. If we were to lower the opacity instead of the fill, it would also reduce the opacity of the effects as well. Click the FX icon and choose Inner Shadow. The blend mode is multiply and the opacity is 90%. Make the angle 90 degrees, the distance 3 pixels, and the size 0. Click drop shadow. Make the blend mode color dodge and click the color box. Pick white and click OK. Reduce the opacity to 35%, the distance to 3 pixels, and the size to 0. Then click OK. Next, we'll add Art Deco lines. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool, place your cursor above your text, and flush with the left of your first character. Drag across a thin rectangular selection to the right edge of your last character. Fill the selection with black, and since black is the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. To copy the text effects to the line that we just made, place your cursor on the word Effects and Alt-click or Option-click on it. This makes a copy of the effects. Drag the copy to the top layer. Lower the fill to 0. Double-click on Inner Shadow to open it in the Layer Style window. Lower the opacity to 60% and click on Drop Shadow. Make the distance 2 pixels and click OK. Make a copy of the line by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Press and hold Shift as you drag the copy straight down below your text the same distance as the top line is from the text. Holding Shift kept it aligned as you dragged it down. Make a copy of this line, press and hold Shift, and drag it down approximately this much. We'll shorten this line by pressing Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool. At the top of your screen, you'll see the width and the height, which are presently at 100% each. Go to the width and type in 60%. Since the chain link links the width and the height, make sure the chain link icon isn't clicked on. Then press Enter or Return. Make a copy of this shorter line, press and hold Shift, and drag it above the top line. Next, I'll show you how to reposition your entire text design on the background. With your top line active, scroll down to your text layer and Shift-click on it to highlight all the layers between it and the top line. Press Ctrl or Command G to place all these layers into a folder. To raise or lower it, press the up or down arrow on your keyboard. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.